Let's have a look at the learning outcomes of this video. It's basically to understand the resource management life cycle and its activities during various phases of a project. Project team and project management team. It's quite important to understand the difference between project team and project management team. Project team involves all people involved in your project's work. On the other hand, project management team is a subset of your project team, focuses on management and administrative tasks. Project management team may consist of the project manager, program manager, and other management roles. In a smaller scale project, it could be just the project manager who is leading and providing the administrative guidance. In a larger scale, it could be a big leadership team that consists of people like the program manager, portfolio manager, as well as program director. The primary responsibility of the project management team is to provide the leadership to the project team members, looking at their own issues, concerns, and making sure that they have everything that is required in order to go and deliver the expected outcome. On the other hand, the project team needs to ensure that they work at their best, work on their optimal capacity, and with the highest quality to achieve the required project goals. There are two key duties of the project manager in the project. First, the project manager or the project management team needs to have influencing capabilities that can be employed not only when dealing with the project management team at large, but also when representing the project team to others outside of the organization. For example, customers, the project sponsor, or others. The project manager shapes and controls factors that can impact the project team. This includes where work is completed and the general work environment as a whole. Any geographical factors when we are working on virtual teams, or those that are spread out over a wide variety of locations. Communication standards must also be set by the project management team. And how does the management team go about soliciting different changes, updates, and feedback to those frontline workers completing the project's objectives? The political environment is also underneath the project manager's purview. It's up to the project manager to make sure that it is a positive work environment, one of clear and concise feedback of direct communication, rather than where we need to worry about looking behind our backs rather than focusing on the project work. Cultural considerations are also an important area for the project management team. After all, especially when working in a global organization with many different team members spread throughout the globe, there may be different expectations in terms of how work is to be completed, how much work is to be completed during a given set of time, and what are considered acceptable methods for getting those objectives accomplished. Finally, there are also different organizational factors. In some cases, the full of support might be required from the organization. In more realistic cases, we often know that there are some doubters or perhaps those who are not fully on board with the plan who are still considered key stakeholders. Those relationships need to be managed. The other key role of the project manager or the project team is to lead. Here, we need to not only uphold our professional and ethical standards for the project team, but also set guidelines and serve as an example to the others. It's up to the project management team to outline the vision for the project. It is that matters for the team and why it's important. Beyond that, it's also up to the project manager or the management team at large to set the standards for how project work is to be completed, how it is that different team members should address one another, and how we can generally build an environment of respect where we can all have a positive experience.